Sigismund was an early 20th century Chinese poet who dedicated his life to the development of literature. His life story, especially his love story with three intelligent women, Zhang Yi, Lin Huiyin, and Lu Xiaoman, quickly spread across all China. A big marble stool is placed in the King's College.
My name is Xiao Yushan. This is my mom, Minju.
So where do you come from?
I'm studying in England, and my mom was coming to join my graduate ceremony. You know, Cambridge is one of the famous university in England that I want to show my mom to this famous Cambridge. And on the other hand, we also know that a Chinese guy, Xu Zhimo, is coming from here. Actually, we are looking for the bridge, the Kang Qiang. Yeah, but we have no idea where is it. Anyway, we are looking for it now. Actually, we do know where is that famous stone.
The marble stone of Xu Zhimo, yes?
Yeah, I think so.
Yes. Well, the college is closed, so you could normally go straight across the bridge.
Yeah.
And it's very easy to get to.
Okay.
But we haven't gone the long route, but
yes.
Apparently what
yes.
you do is you go along there,
yes.
and you turn left at some point, and you mm-hmm. keep walking, and
yes.
you'll see a park.
Okay.
And you can apparently get in into the, to see the marble stone from access from within the park.
Okay. So the park, there is access in the park to moving into
yes.
college?
That's right.
Thousands of people like me visit the marble stone every year in order to experience the emotions of Xu Zhimo's poetry and to see some of the places he would have visited, such as taking a walk along the river banks of Cambridge, or painting the river itself and even to fall in love. Although this famous poet has long since passed away, many fans of his make a journey to Cambridge like me every year to learn more about his works and to experience for themselves the truth, beauty, and freedom of his poetry, and also to see Cambridge through their own eyes to get a better understanding of his poetry.
Rate that by any chance.
Gently I leave, just as I came gently. Okay. I wave my, this one, I don't know how to.
Hand?
No.
Sleeve.
Sleeve.
Yeah.
And I don't take away a piece of cloud.
And that's a traditional
famous poem from Chinese poem.
I should brush up on my Chinese literature then. Very good. I feel enlightened. Thank you very much.
Hello. Haven't you moment? That poem's name is Goodbye Again Cambridge. That poem. The name is Goodbye Again Cambridge. The writer is Xu Zhimo. And he came from China. He spent 2 years here in 1921 to 1922. He writes the poem Goodbye Again Cambridge, and which make Cambridge very famous in China.
Such
as including here, she came to here, especially from China, to visit Cambridge.
I came from the United States.
Yes.
Yeah.
Ah, very good.
Yeah. So this poem is very popular in China.
It's a kind of a little bit sad because he's leaving.
Yes, a farewell.
Yeah.
But also fond wishes. That's very nice.
Yeah. And I think he met his lover here.
Oh, okay. So he met his girlfriend here as well in the UK. She was Chinese as well?
She was
Chinese as well. Oh, okay.
Very romantic.
Yes, so it's a romantic love story as well? Or not just poetry?
This is just a
poetry.
Poetry.
Oh, okay.
Even a single cloud.
Do people usually take clouds when they go?
And when he died, he was only 36. Yeah, spent 2 years living in the King's College and studied here, and he writes the very famous poem, Goodbye Again Cambridge. Maybe you can Google from internet, you will love that poem. That poem is very popular in China.
Excuse me, what's the translation of the title? It's like,
Goodbye Again Cambridge.
Kangqiao
means Cambridge. Means like Zai Hui Yang de Yi.
I've only seen Cambridge written differently with Ken sword. So that's what we do with Japanese.
So Cambridge is a healthy bridge.
For us it's sword bridge.
Sword bridge.
Yeah.
You can find a home for your spiritual.
Okay, cool.
Xu Zhimo. He's very famous in China, and because of this poem, a lot of Chinese people will come to Cambridge and come here, take a walk, maybe every year. A lot of people, because of his poem, so King's College put this door here recently,
Yes, it's new.
Goodbye again, Cambridge. Very quietly I take my leave, as quietly as I came here. Quietly I wave goodbye to the rosy clouds in the western sky, the golden willows by the riverside, our young brides in the setting sun. Their reflections on the shimmering waves always linger in the depths of my heart. The floating harp growing in the sludge sways leisurely under the water. In the gentle waves of Cambridge, I would be a water plant. That pool under the shade of elm trees holds not water, but the rainbow from the sky. Shattered to pieces among the duckweeds, is the sediment of a rainbow like dream? To seek a dream. Just to pole a boat upstream, to where the green grass is more verdant, or to have the boat fully loaded with starlight and sing aloud in the splendour of starlight. But I cannot sing aloud. Quietness is my farewell to music. Even summer insects keep silence for me. Silent is Cambridge tonight. Very quietly I take my leave. As quietly as I came here, Gently I flick my sleeves. Not even a wisp of cloud will I bring away.
Yes, of course, yes. That's why I've come to Cambridge, to see the marble stone, yes?
And the Broadcasting University Lecture in China. I have been taught the works of Xu Shimo from an early age, and my life dream was to visit Cambridge and learn more about this great Chinese port. I came to Cambridge for the first time last year and released some of my emotional feelings for the port's works as I walked along the same river banks as Xu Shimo, and also wrote some poetry, glancing occasionally up at the blue skies of Cambridge and recalling that somewhere up there was Xu Shimo.